Well, we've had that soil health as a goal to, well, to, you know, a sort of a selfish goal to make farming easier for ourselves. I was noticing that as we farmed soils year after year and tilled them year after year, multiple times sometimes, I was seeing the soils kind of wear down a bit, and they were, I was watching our soil samples, which we take yearly. The organic matter levels were dropping, and then when soils would drop, below 2% organic matter, I found that we were really struggling to grow, high quality crops. We were having to irrigate really nearly. It felt like constantly you would water, and then almost immediately, a day or two later, need to go right back in and water again. And so we knew we had to change that, and we've struggled and done a few different things to change that, but we're heading in the right direction now. The benefits are primarily water related and soil organic matter, which go hand in hand anyway. But we're seeing our soil organic matters levels rise or at least stay where they are, and we are seeing a real strong reduction in water use on that acreage, and we have I feel like a good nutrient program, and I feel like that we have no nutrients. I feel like the nutrients aren't subject to leaching the way they are in bare ground. Well, soil health, when I see that our soils aren't running into the low spots on a heavy rain, I feel better about using the land. There are a lot of people who would say that farming in traditional ways has depleted soil, and I don't want to be a person that's leaving this land in a state that's of less usefulness to the next person, no matter what they choose to do. And so I think that if I can keep it just vibrant and healthy with microorganisms and soil organic matter, that we'll all be better off. It's not a earth-shattering revelation that I've come onto here, but it feels right when you're improving your soil organic matter and your crops are growing healthy, more healthy.